Welcome to the third video in our series on Grover's algorithm. In this video, we will go through a complete example of Grover's algorithm, carefully explaining each step to make the process clear. We are given a function that takes 2 bits as input and produces a single bit as output. Our goal is to find the input value, referred to as x, for which the function evaluates to 1. The algorithm uses an oracle that is aware of the function behavior. In our example, the algorithm knows that the function returns 1 for the input 10 or 2 in decimal. Let's construct the quantum circuit for Grover's algorithm. The circuit is based on the concepts discussed in the previous video. The first register will represent the domain of the function, and since our function domain consists of 2 bits, this register will consist of 2 qubits. The second register will always be consist of 1 qubit, initialized to the state ket1. We begin by applying Hadamard gates to the both registers. Next, we apply the oracle, which is represented as the operator UF. When UF is applied to the state composed of ketx and ket-, it modifies the phase of the state. Specifically, the output of UF will be -1 raised to the power f(x) multiplied by ketx and ket-. The next step is what is often referred to as the diffusion operation. This operation involves 3 sub-steps. First, we apply Hadamard gate to the first register. Then we use an operator called U0. Finally, we apply Hadamard gate to the first register once again. Note that when U0 is applied to a state ketx, it leaves the state unchanged if x is 0. For any other value of x, it flips the sign of the state, effectively reflecting it about the state ket0. These steps together form what is known as 1 Grover rotation. Now, let's calculate how many Grover rotations are needed, as we might have to extend our circuit based upon the number of Grover rotations. As we have discussed in the previous video, the number of rotations is determined by the formula, the floor of pi divided by 4 multiplied by square root of total number of elements in the domain divided by the number of solutions minus 1/2. In this example, the total number of elements in the domain, capital N, is 4, and the number of solutions, A, is 1, because the function returns true for only 1 input. Plugging these values in the formula, the result is floor of approximately 1.0707, which is equals to 1. This means that for our example, a single Grover rotation is sufficient. After performing this rotation, we measure the first register to find the value of x for which f(x) is equal to 1. Next, we divide the quantum circuit into 6 stages labeled as ket psi 1, through cat's eye 6. To clearly observe the transformations at each step. For the first stage, cat's eye 1, the system is initialized to the state cat 00 in the first register and cat 1 in the second register. In the second stage, cat's eye 2, we apply Hadamard gates to both registers. This operation transforms the first register into equal superposition of all possible input states, represented as 1 over square root of 4 multiplied by equal superposition of all inputs from cat 0 to cat 3. The second register transforms to the state cat minus. In the third stage, cat psi 3, we apply the oracle operation which modifies the phase of quantum states based on the function's output. The state corresponding to the value of x for which f of x is equal to 1 will have their sign flipped. In our example, this applies to the state associated with x equals to 1, 0. We then move on to the diffusion operator, which involve 3 steps. First, we apply Hadamard gate to the first register. To quickly compute Hadamard gate's output, we use a tabular method, as explained in one of my earlier videos. The table contains all possible 2 bits values as columns, specifically 00, 01, 10, and 11. The rows represent the current states of the first register, that is cat 00, cat 01 minus cat 10 and cat 11. Each cell in the table is filled with the product of row and column values, where plus denotes plus 1 and minus denotes minus 1. At the bottom of the table, we compute the sum of all cells of a column. After summing the values, we find the resultant state of first register is 2 times cat 0 minus 2 times cat 1 plus 2 times cat 2 plus 2 times cat 3. We also apply a normalization factor, which in this case is 1 over 2. This normalization shows that quantum state remain valid. At cat psi 4, the table output becomes the state of our first register, while the second register remains in the state cat minus. Next, we apply U0 operation to the first register. This operation flips the sign of every element in the superposition state, except the state cat 0. Following this, we apply the Hadamard gates to the first register again to complete the diffusion operation. The results of these steps, or cat psi 6, is a quantum state where the first register collapses to cat psi 2 with an amplitude of 1. This means that when we measure the first register, we obtain the value 2 with 100% probability. This is indeed the correct value of x, where the function f of x outputs 1. And that concludes our example of Grover's algorithm. If you like this video, please consider supporting this channel. See you in the next video. Bye.